There's no little red light. Take it up.
It's true. There is no red. Are you sure you're?
I'm 100% certain. Okay.
If we sit here and talk this whole time, it's not recording. God,
I know it doesn't have a light.
This is why I have the second audio thing, is I can look at it right now and it's recording. I can tell.
Well,
so
yeah,
worst case, we have a podcast without video.
I'm waiting for Balls to be like, yeah, it's recording.
Oh, what?
The recording light's back here? Fuck you all, it's blinking.
Why did you buy a camera that doesn't have a record light?
If it's blinking, it's because it's paused, right?
Why don't you unpause it?
Sit like you're gonna sit.
Pause.
Is still in frame?
Am I still in frame?
Am I in frame?
Yes, there's a fucking image. There's an image right here. I see you all.
Pause, he was leaning forward.
Pause, am I in frame when I lean back like this?
Pause, am I in frame?
Pause, are you in frame?
Pause is
gonna kill us. I'm gonna go fucking lock these doors, set this goddamn place on fire.
He's
gonna break out his tomahawk.
Wes is in frame.
Well, that makes sense. I have a hard time believing Badge.
I'll hold my hands.
Check if Badge is in frame. I really want you to edit.
Apparently, PAX make me fucking blind or something.
You're like, I can't see me in that at all.
The fuck,
Paz? Hey, Paz, I think you turned off the recording. I'm gonna go check his
What's the time limit on the video recording?
Next fucking comment gets a fucking bottle full of water in their face.
That is a legitimate good question.
How much memory is there?
Is there a not recording light that we know it stops?
That is a thing on some cameras.
I know.
Does that mean I'm just saying, if you don't throw a bottle of water in either Chad or Jason's face, will we ever take your threats credibly in the future?
How dare you egg him on?
I haven't said a thing. All right. I pointed at Goon.
I just said something at me.
I wasn't making a question.
But
did you
a
see
comment.
A question?
He said
mark?
A comment. He said a comment. No, the person makes
a comment.
Comet.
Fuck
it.
Comet.
Have we started?
I'm pretty sure this is it.
Did someone check the eclipse?
This is good.
It's tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
It's a full moon tonight.
It's not a full moon tonight. If it's
why would anybody be more likely to check the eclipse than you?
Honestly,
is Kurt J. Mack here?
I'm the one that mentioned it.
Why would an eclipse know
it was tomorrow? So he's probably right.
Tomorrow night, I think. Full moon,
it has to be a full moon to have an eclipse.
Yeah.
What category
is
it?
It's nearly a full moon tonight.
But not exactly.
It's total.
Total eclipse of the moon?
Yeah.
It's a total eclipse of the moon.
Yeah. We're good now.
spot the old man.
Is he going to look?
He's like, yup, it's a full moon.
Oh no, we had this whole conversation the way back, and he said he thought it was full.
It must be on the other side of the house. I don't see it.
All right, so
maybe it's fucking
it's eclipsing.
I don't think it's eclipsing.
Idiot!
Sam, I thought you were an astrophysicist.
I'm almost positive it's not eclipsing.
It was really
uncertain.
So
fuck you all.
See, don't worry, Paz.
We're totally not wasting recording time right now.
I'm pretty certain this is good shit. I put this to my channel in a heartbeat. I hope you're uploading this.
No.
Well, fuck, let me have it.
No.
This is a goddamn disservice to the internet.
Yeah.
Yes?
No.
What about the fans, Pause? What about the fans?
You hate the fans, man.
Are you going to throw a bottle of water in the fans' faces, too?
There's a beautiful waxing gibbous out there. Tomorrow's the...
Waxing...
I'm pretty sure that's out of the porno title.
Waxing gibbous.
That's definitely a porno title.
That's illegal, isn't it?
Masturbating monkey?
Waxing a gibbous?
Not in Thailand.
Can you check a bike in Thailand? You can wax it.
Did we wax that yesterday?
We did.
It's not for a gibbous, though.
Welcome to the Mindcrack Podcast. I'm Wes Wilson. I'm your guest host. And I'm here with a bunch of assholes.
Can you just be on our podcast? Like,
are you going to edit in the music so that we have like a lead-in or not? Are you just going
to
cut?
It's time to listen to the Mindcrack Podcast.
Wow, Rob, you have such great tunes.
So, what did you guys think of the show?
Are you really the host?
I guess.
Mr. Moderator.
I will. I'll be happy to.
Are
you going to take stupid-ass questions from Twitter?
I am.
Who can you go, J-Mod?
Will Goode shut the fuck up? No.
What was that question, the yelling question?
I don't fucking know. I have no idea why that was relevant at all.
Well, that's just it. I don't necessarily know all your in-jokes.
Yeah.
So I saw it, it looked in-jokey, and I thought, well, it involves Goode, and it's an in-joke. Maybe it'll get a laugh.
Well, it got a laugh, but no one knew what the fuck they were laughing at.
Yeah. It was a really awkward laugh.
Yeah, that was really like, awkward laugh.
Okay.
Was it saying, like,
no, there was a couple of more awkward laughs in there.
But might have been, like, their username, and they wanted a shout-out.
It could be. What was it? It was Gmon, and what else? There was one other thing you could yell?
Like a pony or something. What?
Posicorn.
Oh, you don't have my hand or something? Yeah. What's going on? Now, does that come
from anything? Posicorn? Oh, have you not seen the Posicorn picture?
No.
Oh, God.
That's... Oh, is it the guy in the thong?
With you?
I guess.
Oh. Is it? Yeah, there's a Wesenactyl picture.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, God, he's going to pull it up.
Internet search.
I was so shocked whenever the question came up about what's the most famous person you've met through YouTube that you didn't say, I rode the Hulk with the Hulk.
Why didn't you say that?
It wasn't my show. I was featuring you guys.
I was saying that during the panel,
A few times you commented, though.
I did.
Wait, which Hulk?
The Hulk.
I rode with
Hulk. Like Lou Ferrigno?
No, not him.
That is so insensitive.
Yeah, Mark Ruffalo.
Sorry.
No, I rode the Hulk with the Hulk ride at Minecon with Mark Ruffalo. Right.
Really? Why was he there?
Because his kid likes Minecraft.
Cool.
Yeah. And he was there.
Somebody else must have been Hulk, right?
So was he like flipping out or something with ride starts?
He said, "Don't take a selfie with me."
Well, there's one that actually falls in a unicorn.
So you probably did anyway.
I did. He actually was really nice. He was really upbeat and happy to take pictures with people.
Uh-huh. Yeah, but he was very much, I'm just here with my kid, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But I mean,
of course he got special treatment. Which,
yeah. I mean, he got a lot of
special treatment. So you got to sit next to Wes. How special can he get?
Yeah.
No, he didn't sit next to me. He sat in the front, actually.
The width comes with like an asterisk.
Yeah, right? I did too, this whole fucking time.
You've exaggerated the story.
I was on the same car with him.
You weren't sitting on his... No, you embellished it.
Yeah, I thought you were sitting next to him.
You conveyed the impression that you were sitting next to him.
Chad and I did not ride in the car together because we were in the same car.
No, I was in the same seat thing with you.
Seat thing?
The front area.
Here's the most important part.
I thought it was like you got on the plane and sat next to him.
No, we were on the same train. I sat behind him. I sat one row behind him.
Was he method acting as Bruce Banner on the ride?
Yes.
Did you touch his hair? You were right behind him.
No,
I touched him. You were behind him.
Right, this is starting to get like really sexual. Did you and the Hulk make out? Like.
No. Later on that night in my dreams.
Did he Hulk out on you?
Hulkamania!
That's a different Hulk.
Yeah, I know.
Are you sure you even rode the Hulk with the Hulk?
I did. I've got pictures that are totally not photoshopped. Totally.
Because you showed me a photo that night. I thought you were sitting beside him. So it was like you were back here somewhere.
No.
It is a photo.
It would be like you were Mark and I was Wes. So yeah. I would have to stare at you really creepy.
Yeah.
So I'm still trying to find this image for him.
It's really great in a
somehow
podcast.
Somehow Zisto comes up with a Posicorn search.
Yeah. What?
My logo comes up in a Posicorn search.
I thought we were talking only in order, actually. So.
Hey, thank God. Oh, wait, no. We'd skip over you, wouldn't we? And then
it's Zisto's turn. Shut the fuck up.
But everybody here was pretty happy with how the panel went, right?
Yeah. I think there was a slight lull when we ran out of questions, but then it picked back up and was fine.
Yeah.
On the stream, the numbers went down when you ran out of questions, but...
Which is weird, I don't understand that.
Well, you said we ran out of questions.
But what the fuck, I thought we were just gonna leave? Like, alright, we're out.
Okay, we're not. You do not understand the
thanks for that,
computer. They have, like, the attention span of an ant. I don't wonder how... They probably have pretty good attention spans.
No, they don't. But
ants?
No.
Okay.
Well, I mean, the truth is...
Yeah, they do. What do you know? Ants will travel a chemical trail from, like, one end of a yard to another.
But they have to have...
For an ant, that's, like, weeks of lifetime.
They don't, like, keep it in their head, though. They're, like... Biology, guys.
They don't think
of it. Thank you for standing up for the ants. Yeah. The proper analogy, I think,
is
goldfish.
Can someone take ant?
Yeah.
Either or?
No, not either or. Not either or.
They're very similar.
I might be goldfish and ants. Just go and give them...
But I mean, but like there was all kinds of things we could do. We could have gone to audience questions. Just because I was out of questions doesn't mean that the show was ending.
Look,
I mean, if most panels don't have...
It was at 5,500, and then when you mentioned that, it dropped down to like 48.
So I'm really surprised there was only one question from the Twitch chat that made it.
No, no, no. He was like, is there any good questions from the Twitch chat? And the guy on the side is like,
no. Is that what he did?
Yeah.
At the beginning of the stream, like in the chat, right when you guys were starting, somebody actually asked, are they taking questions?
Yeah.
And the channel, whoever was running the channel said, this panel is not taking questions from the chat. And so as soon as he said no, and Wes said, well, fuck you guys. We didn't say that. He was like, oh,
I'm so disappointed in you, Twitch. Boo!
They were all like, their version of fuck you, Wes, we wanted to ask, but they said we couldn't.
Wait, maybe that's why they left, because you said we're out of questions, and you also said, well, that was already from Twitch. He said,
you're
no,
like, so, do we got any Twitch questions? Yeah. Oh, no? Well, we're out.
Then they started asking tons and tons of questions.
Yeah, but then they actually did find a good question.
No, they got a good question.
Oh, yeah, the great question.
No, that, by the way, that question never ran through that chat.
Of course not.
Really? That was why did you even ask that?
Because he felt like he needed,
that was a promotional question.
Which question was that?
What are you guys going to do with PAX?
Our panel, for one. I guess that's what we all should have said. Our panel.
Well, we're leaving after like, this. Actually,
after this panel, we're gonna go home.
We're gonna go home. Our flight's in 2 hours. I'll see
you. We're gonna go. Let's
I can't wait for the every 13-minute mid-roll.
Whatever BTC talks.
As soon as we started, they advertised PAX South. The instant we started up.
Yeah. So that was 30 minutes of.
Actually, before anyone asks any questions, BTC's not here because we'd have to start rolling ads.
I was gonna say that.
But no, I'm just joking, he's sleeping. Like, it's. Why is he sleeping? We're all awake.
It's so. He had a busy day.
Oh my god.
He's been up and down.
It's like 2 a.m.
He's a tuckered little guy.
He is. He's plum tuckered.
I thought when we started talking that you'd be able to, like, you know, cut some things out of this.
No.
There was absolutely no.
No.
Content will be zero.
That was a good question. You know, why is it BTC? And then instantly.
But steer away from this, okay?
It's a secret.
Yeah. And for those of you
we can't. We'd love to tell you, but we can't.
You gotta make sure you pause enough.
Oh, okay.
I would like to tell you about it. But right now I can't.
But I hope this moment is brought to you by Duracell.
Gotta be good. I got such a hard time.
Residuals now or
something? Yeah,
better. It was the first to add.
I feel like I was the only nervous one for the podcast. Was anyone else even slightly nervous? Like
for this?
Like,
for the podcast?
No, I mean, I'm not.
No, I wasn't nervous at all.
I actually got really nervous, but I think part of it was because I was sticking halfway out of a table, like on one end. I was worried about. I was in my chair was this close to the edge of the stage. I'm like holding on to Badge while
the table's only like here. The domino effect. They would have just obliterated.
Yeah. Everybody was judging your right leg.
They could have been. And I was seriously sitting there like, well, I don't know what to do with my legs because these people
are like, what do I do with my legs? You should have just embraced it.
I only have one.
That's what happens when they move that podium. He sat there and be like, but then they moved the cloths together or whatever.
Do you think anybody realized there was no table in front of Nipper?
No.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. You should have just like had like a water bottle, just like dropped it.
You had the people would have been like,
but it was better than having the podium and not.
Originally there was a podium there. Nivers was behind.
So they were like more than accommodating to Mubu, which was awesome about them. So
they were. It was gonna be the podium, and then Wes at the podium, and then Nivers staring.
I think if you had fallen off, it would have been a great moment. You probably should have taken one for the team.
I could have. I was thinking about it.
But you said you should have gone and grabbed me.
Well, I would have accidentally fall off under the bar.
Let me ask you that. So that was the thing is, we got to watch the edge of the stage. We're really tight in here. And they're like, okay, we're going to put a bar up on this one side of the stage and leave the other side completely open still.
They knew
our
partners.
That side was like, the chair
was
like, right.
Well, not only that, they had the stairs coming up, so they couldn't put that there.
We should have had someone else on the edge. Have them fall off, then you could rescue them and resuscitate them.
I don't want to have a nurse!
I've got this!
One of you guys, I don't know if I would have really thought fast enough.
Which maybe if we set him on fire, you'd be like, oh, yeah, got this.
Yeah. Imagine stomping it out.
I carry my hose with me all the time.
This is the best thing I wanted to fight fires and stomp their face.
You'd be doing badge of justice.
Oh. It was really early in the morning, though. I wish we could have had one that was more like 2 or something. God.
Well, when you think about it in context, though, 10:30 is really not super early in the morning, but the process of getting there and getting set up was made for a very early day.
Out in the sticks as well.
Yeah. Nothing quite like having Seth walk into your room at 7 a.m. 7 a.m. alarm. 7 a.m. alarm.
Yeah, he sent me a text because he didn't know which room was mine. He sent me a text.
I still don't know where you sleep in this house. This house is so big, I don't know
where
you sleep.
Let me read word for word the text message.
Oh, God, I can't find it.
Can you confirm you're awake? I don't know where you're awake.
Can you confirm? I could not confirm or deny.
No one in the house knew when you were sleeping. I was like, is he sleeping downstairs? Because I went down there and you weren't there. Apparently you were in the shower at the time when I went to check.
Yeah, and
just nobody knew.
Well, because by the time I found the text message, I had already talked to you, but it's funnier to say I was just saying.
Yeah. You did lockpick our door.
Yeah.
I don't know, magically you lockpick
me and this guy
for like 5
like,
minutes just sitting there pushing on the door trying
me and him were like wide awake, we're both on our stuff. This guy's like opening the door,
it's
like,
glass sliding door to a room too. I didn't even know if it was a bedroom. Like, this isn't my
room.
Is this my room? Trying to open the door.
And Seth's head pokes through the...
You guys up?
Why are you two locking your bedroom door?
Because...
Here's why.
Okay, wait, answer fast.
We had sex.
Okay.
No, what happened was...
Make sure
BTC,
have a chair up against the other
BTC
door as well.
And Goode actually did like a little house tour the very first day, and people were like, well, we know where this is. There's one guy who said like I graduated and had a party there, so we're like, well, let's lock our door so they'll murder everyone else first before us, so...
That's exactly what we did.
Really? You locked your door because you thought there would be murderous fans coming
not
over?
Not only did we lock the door, we actually propped
up the door with a chair. A chair under the handle because that door wouldn't actually close.
They think that you are murderers.
Not only that.
100%.
They just don't want to be the first ones to get killed.
But it was all dismantled by Seth at 7 a.m.
Anyone in there?
I could have killed your ass.
What if Seth was a murderer?
He did take like 5 minutes to actually get in the
door. You're 100% not the murderer.
That's not 5 minutes.
Because if it took him 5 minutes to do that, and then probably 5 minutes to text you, then he came back in the room. 7:10 snooze.
I couldn't believe how persistent. Like after the first try, I would be like, screw this.
Are we sure Seth's not a robot? Can you confirm?
You gotta say ask one me. If true, say zero if
you gotta ask him to keep awake. Keep awake. Are you awake, brah? There you go. Lesson learned.
You're awake, brah.
Brah. Brah. Sorry.
Brah. Are you awake? Breh.
Breh.
That's the Canadian version of brah.
Yeah.
Breh.
No, it was off with sorry. Are you awake, breh?
Sorry, are you.
Are you about to be awake? Boop.
Fucking hell, mate.
So we got up at 7 o'clock.
We went into English real fast there.
Yeah.
No, we didn't.
So we got up at 7 o'clock. We were on the road by 8. We got there at 8:30. And we were 2 hours early for our 10:30 pay.
Wes is looking at me because I'm the one that demanded that we do that because I really was not convinced that we would even be out of here by 9 if we said we'd be out of here by 8.
If
it wasn't for Seth being a walking alarm, we probably wouldn't have been.
Guys, I'm not a robot.
I had set my alarm for 7:30. I had already woke up.
Prove it.
Seth,
can you write a proof that you're not?
Go ahead, world's flashing.
Should we cut you to see if you bleed? Like,
yes.
Please?
Please.
We want blood.
Terminator bleeds. That's nothing.
We're not that advanced yet.
What did you just say?
The Terminator bleeds.
The termites can bleed?
The Terminator.
Terminator.
Do we need a translator?
I think so.
Shit.
I did not hear it.
We need to get you.
Like, in Britain, they call it Terminator. The termites.
I think just need some subtitles for the
No, he's blind. He always forgets his contacts a lot at these conventions.
Oh, so
no,
blindness makes him not hear, probably.
He can't read.
No. That goes along with the blindness. Okay. He's just.
Like, he's just old.
Yeah. He's...
Fuck you guys.
Not even here.
There's a couple of gray hairs in here.
There is not.
You've got a lot of, like, right there.
Okay, there's some gray hairs. Wow.
At least you got some.
Are we all inspecting Gooch's head?
What do you mean some? I'll buy some hair.
Maybe okay, you, I got a, if you I would got groom a couple yourself, of brown hairs here.
I shaved before we left. My house. Not like all the way down, but I groomed it.
Not all the way down?
My house.
He groomed what?
He didn't shave. He said he didn't shave everything.
He said he didn't shave.
What
all
did
the
you hair. Shave? I see a lot of hair.
Yeah.
No, I groomed it to an equal level with the other hairs of its.
You manscaped.
All it, him and all his friends are all the same length.
Oh, we friends now.
What's this?
This seems right like an innuendo.
That's Jerry. Leave Jerry alone.
Oh God.
How have we liked the house so far?
Egg house has been amazing.
It's very nice.
It's far away, but
the party
it's too far.
Yeah, the party.
And it looks deceiving because you can't see it, but like there's paint on this fucking stone wall.
Oh, it's really
wow.
Yeah.
There. Yeah,
it's kind of like yeah.
It, this house has not been kept in good repair.
There's a fireplace.
BWO would not have signed off on this house when it was finished.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was 11 years in rental so far, so it's been through.
Yeah,
it has to be. Yeah, you think you upkeep, right?
No.
No.
No? Why not?
Because fuck that, it costs money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When you can make money.
It's a $2 million
house. White paint costs thousands of dollars. Like,
but working costs money. You gotta hire people.
Yeah, that's why there's white paint all over that property.
Have you seen the soffits and stuff outside? It's rotting away. It's,
yeah.
Soffits?
What's a soffit?
It's a British for
eavesdrop.
Because you don't understand
gutter?
It doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
Not eavesdrop.
That's the thing. I was having a termite moment.
The bits around the roof. Where the soffit. Roof
gutter.
Gutters?
No, not the gutters. Underneath the gutters, the flat bit.
Like
the overhang of the roof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know that I ever knew that was a soffit. Yeah.
The soffit.
Interesting. It's not a soffit. Don't ever use that word.
I'm sorry.
This is blurry with the edge.
Our soffit is rotten, mate.
In fact, I'll go so far as to say that when I walk down on the patio there that leans over the rocks.
Yeah, that fence is...
Well, but I walked out there and the rest of the house was in such disrepair, I was extremely conscious of every movement of that patio.
Yeah, whenever we had all the people here, I actually was worried if a lot of people went out there that they would all die. I've never stepped out of that with another person.
You look at the railing, the whole railing.
I jumped up and down a little bit, so I think
The roof was amazing and actually felt safer
because I said this is moving too much.
That's why when y'all sealed off the roof so that nobody go up there during the party, I'm like, I'm not sure we're saving more lives.
Yeah, that's true. It could have actually been safer to have everybody on the roof as opposed to the deck.
No, it's really dark up there.
It's dark, but at least you have a slight overhang.
I just imagine,
a slight soffit.
And so they bounce on the way down.
They would actually probably fall onto the deck that people are standing on and collapse the whole thing. But I mean,
onto the thorns. Are, of course, surrounding the entire property
on the way down to the deck
by the rocks.
By the rocks to the ocean.
Yeah.
Eventually, you'd roll into the ocean.
The ocean that really and farted by sharks. Stinks.
Yes.
What the hell?
Oh my! This whole island farted like 2 days ago.
It did it again today.
Oh God!
It stunk like.
It smelled like an oyster shat.
It did. It smelled like somebody had taken a bunch of oysters and laid them out.
And I was like, "Yeah, this house is great."
It's
in damn like there's paint everywhere.
It's
fucking awesome. The rail's gonna fall into the sea any moment. It's great.
But I'm fucking living in the ocean or anything. So.
It's a great house to entertain in, though. As we
it was.
It.
Yes.
We found it to be a great house to entertain.
Yeah. There was some random guy downstairs climbing rocks this morning.
He was.
I have video of that.
We were kind of scared. He was 100% the murderer.
Was he lost?
He had
soldier
a gun.
From the party?
Did he?
Like, did everybody get out of here okay? We're sure
he looked
nobody's
like
he was. I mean,
like,
it's America, it's possible.
Like, I know, like, who noticed him? I think it was.
We all stood right at that window and stared at him.
Yeah, he waved up at him.
Yeah, it was like, at first. We see this guy climbing. I'm like, sit here. And he hid. And
he hid.
No, like
there.
But yeah, he didn't see him like at first because he went on this like little rock that he pops up. He's like, oh
my
and then,
god,
like,
there is
more people come. And then eventually he looks up. He's like,
there's like six of us.
So many people just staring and watching him.
Well, I noticed a couple people out in the front yard of the next door neighbor's house. And if you look out the side window over here, there's like this pool out there. It's a bean-shaped pool, but then it's got like...
And there's an amazing statue of like this woman like riding a wave like in between these two pools that...
Yeah.
are halfway filled with the greenest, ugliest sprite water.
And it's surrounded by...
The wooden deck around it, all it is the cross beams. Like, all the wood.
Everything else is rotten away.
Yeah.
So there's somebody there?
But that's just it. I thought it was empty as well. From looking at it from the back, it looked abandoned. Well, then when we were coming up, when I was coming back from breakfast, getting breakfast up this morning, I noticed that there were two guys standing in the front yard. And I took a look, and they were obviously doing some planning of some kind. And then, like, as I was pulling up to our house, I looked at the front of the house. The front of the house looks great. And there's plants, and it's pretty, and people have cared for it. Obviously, the back is just not worth it.
Right.
It's like a TV set.
The back is always worth it.
But it was, I don't know. But I was joking around that we should go sneak into that house in the middle of the night last night. Can you imagine?
But people actually live there. Like,
there's a lot of salty spray out the back, so you gotta watch out for.
What?
There's a lot of salty spray out the back.
Oh.
Because of the ocean.
Oh. Was that some kind of like, some clever British thing?
It was just a thinly veiled innuendo.
Oh, okay.
I'm pretty sure.
Innuendo.
Pretty thinly. Do we want to talk about the party?
Window?
About the party.
Let's talk about the party. We had a cool party.
Yeah, we did.
Professor Shy Guy opened up with some Hal Jordan rings. Never mind. Nobody's going to understand that.
I get it.
Against
like, all of his fingers had green lights.
That was a sad high five. You guys need to redo.
Okay, here we go. Ready? He had the little green glowy things all over his fingers.
They're like rave.
You know, it's weird because I've been at so many cons where he's at, I never got to hear him perform, and I'm disappointed in myself.
I was very impressed with him. He was pretty badass. He put on like an act he would put on for hundreds. Yeah, and he had like this jacket with glowing lights on it and finger rings that were glowing green. And he was jumping all over the place and like going from room to room.
Yeah, he pulling the lamp. Like,
yeah, he was moving the lamp to like create dynamic lighting.
And then the other thing is like a lot of people, he would start in with like his chiptune-y kind of stuff as his backing track and he'd start singing. And then he'd pull the guitar out and start wailing on it and people would be like, what?
Yeah, exactly.
You know? They don't expect that part of the show to be live.
But it was so badass.
Yeah,
it
was. He was very good. So check out Professor Shy Guy. And then...
on YouTube.
There's one part that really scared me though, when he was doing like the lighting. He jumped, the chair kind of pushed
back. Oh my god, I thought it was over right there, and that was over, completely over. Oh my god.
I like how he put a chair backwards, and he was like drinking out of a water bottle, and then he like sprayed it all over himself. And
then he kind of sat in that chair. Got a wet
ass.
And
he started singing, I'm a maniac, main. Oh, sorry, that's an old people joke.
Badge left.
He saw Flashdance. and then approaching Nirvana.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
We were lucky enough to have them come up and
they mixed live like forever.
Yeah.
They were mixing live for about 7 hours total. They did a full like 2.5 to 3 hour set and then they just loved their music so much that they just kept playing.
Yeah, after like the party died down, so people left and it was just like me and Sev and they were doing like this roulette thing where they'd play one song and then the other guy would have to go up and transition their song, and then so on and so forth. And that went on for like 3 hours. It was cool. It was awesome.
It was amazing.
I don't think they left until like 5 or something, right?
They left at 6.
Oh, was it 6?
They left at 6.
Man. Yeah.
Suck it!
Yeah.
And there were a lot of people here. I know Wolf 21.
Yeah, we had like at least 200 people, I think.
Yeah, yeah. 200 divided by another integer.
No.
Yes. That's correct.
I'm really happy that many people.
Are you sure
out.
It was a multi? Whatever.
It was a rational number.
What algorithm?
We had a rational number of people here, and I can prove it.
Can we just make a spreadsheet really quick?
I would love a spreadsheet.
So yeah, like not many people showed up, but that's because one, we lived really, really far away, and
it was
two,
still a shit ton of
people. Yeah, 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 but I mean, like people, right? 200 people is a lot.
Yeah. Yeah. It was like 60 though, right?
I counted 48.
48. 48. Okay. That's.
It was awesome. Yeah.
It was.
Did you really?
This house could like, this house could have held twice as many people easily.
Oh yeah.
Sitting space for everyone is.
But there was 15 guys that were going to come, and it was going to be basically $500 to come here and back.
We were actually kind of willing to fund that.
Yeah, I mean, and they were friends. Like, I was kind of excited about them coming, and they're like, oh, we don't think we can afford that cab ride. It's just too much money. And so I ran around. I'm like, come on, chip in. And we gathered together.
Well, you walked away with $2.
We had $200 to offer to them for their cab ride.
It was like our own little Kickstarter.
Yeah. It's like a party Kickstarter.
I said we should have a real Kickstarter for people to pay for our party that they can't come to.
I have seen
what would the perks be for that Kickstarter? We'll send you a personal photo of us enjoying the party.
This is the perk.
That's only the $50 tier.
We talked about how awesome it was.
There is a subreddit called Shitty Kickstarters, which is worth
looking at. Free advertising.
That is brilliant.
At the $40 level, Paws will pee your name in the bushes outside the house.
It doesn't really do anything.
Wow. Right? Wow, just like pee in bushes.
Pause, are you sure you're peeing my name? Yeah. Don't worry.
I have great pee control. This video is exclusive to you. I didn't send this to everyone.
I'd have to drink a lot of water.
Thanks, Jim.
Dave, half an hour ago, you Snapchatted me from the toilet.
Oh, God, this guy has a really long name.
Yeah. Come back an hour later.
Done. Did you guys see anything in PAX that you guys like?
Yeah.
Thanks, Twitch.
That was the one question from
that. I
really didn't look at much. In fact, the only thing I looked at, like on the show floor, was the new Oculus Rift,
which was amazing. Yeah, it was incredible.
Because I have the DevKit 1, the first version of it. And it's like, it's a little pixelated when you first put it on. Once you get going, it's, you know, it's good. But this one, like, everything about it was a lot better. The head tracking, the response time when you, like, move your head quickly was, like, it on the DevKit 1, it's kind of blurry, but you could do it. It was great.
Was the
when
Facebook you do integration? What? That was the whole ass of Facebook.
Yeah. Someone give me a hula hoop. And the resolution obviously was much better, frame rate. Yeah, it was, everything about it was just...
I think you can sign in with your eyes.
John Carmack programming.
Yeah, I guess so.
Did you go get in the big ball?
What was the name of that game? It was...
Was there really a line to get in? I saw somebody in the ball at all times, and I saw a line in the general area, but I didn't see that they actually connected together in any way.
It looked like it was a pretty big line.
Was it more of a...
All the way along the side.
But you did eventually get to the ball.
You would eventually get inside the ball. Yeah. The Manster ball.
Yeah, it's the Manster ball. It's the VR ball. Yeah. But you did that before, Goode, right? Were you the one that was telling me you had
done that? I've done that before.
Chad did.
Yeah, and the problem with the big... Yeah, VR ball.
The problem is it doesn't fit in your bedroom.
Yeah, right. Where the hell does it fit that? Like, what the hell?
It doesn't matter because the ball is so big that it has so much momentum that when you're walking, you're like, you're like really trying to move this gigantic plastic ball. And then if you want to turn directions, like you trip yourself up because it's turning in this direction. You want to go that way. You turn your body and start to walk, but the ball is still moving.
You fall, starts going up the edge, plops back down.
Complete BS.
You're always walking uphill because it's...
Yeah, you're always walking uphill. Yeah.
Why does it have to be a fucking ball? It seems like you could have...
Because it's
like,
360 degrees of motion.
No, I understand.
Well, you asked!
I don't understand why this can't be done on a flat surface.
It can be.
It's a motion track.
There was something.
Okay.
Like half speed.
But then you're not in a Manster ball.
Yeah.
Never mind.
How do you hook the cords up?
It's wireless.
I think it had
When I did it, there wasn't the cart to stabilize yourself.
When I did it, there wasn't the cart. Like you would just fall and keep going.
You just like start running and you're like, totally.
Oh, that'd be awesome, Katamari Damacian PAX. That's all I can imagine.
It's like actual live action Katamari. Yeah.
It actually rolls off the platform that it's on and it just starts going through all the booths.
Picking it up, rolling out the cosmos. Yeah,
that'd be awesome.
My favorite part of the Oculus thing was it was the demo where you were looking at the living room and you were fighting with the little fighting guys,
avatars.
Avatars.
And you could jump over to the other guy's, like, and get up in his face. And every time that happened, I would jump.
I was playing it with Chad. Yeah. And, like, I would put my little guy up on his lap, but it was kind of low, so you couldn't necessarily see it. But every time I do it, I could just see his character, because I can't see anything, of course, next to me. I would just see his character, and all of a sudden it's like this
yeah.
human guy sitting in this chair, and all of a sudden I would just be like...
Was he wearing clothes?
I think you did it right.
Right.
It was funny, because we used the media badges, and whenever she sat me down, she didn't know where we were from media-wise or whatever, and... So the other person sat down, she told me, she's like, I just want to let you know she's a gamer, so don't feel bad if she really beats you badly.
Did you win?
Oh, yeah. No, I destroyed her.
Oh, nice.
Oh, take that, gamer.
Yeah, suck it, gamer.
Media people aren't gamers. I see how it is.
Yeah, it was. I thought it was similar.
I usually have more of an interest in kind of the indie game side of things, and most of the big booths, like, it, they seem to be too crowded, and I wasn't really interested.
Yeah,
there
was some big ass queues, wasn't there?
But like, were you guys attracted by the?
Shut the hell up! Can I confirm that you're awake? He was a legitimate term.
The indie section was pretty big, and I wandered through it. And I think a lot of them kind of, like, blend together. Like, they don't stand out individually. Yeah. The one that I found that I really liked was by the studio that made Bastion.
Yes. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. It's called Transistor. I couldn't remember the name. I had to look it up.
Yeah.
But it's a pretty... It was, like, one of the ones that sort of stood out. Like, oh, this is unique right away when I started looking at it.
Yeah.
They use the exact same voice for the voiceover.
Well, yeah, that's because it's probably the guys that do the game. But the guy who did Bastion and Transistor did all the plot and story and everything for it.
Mm-hmm.
Every time I went by that booth, he was in there.
Yeah,
his name is Greg Kasavin.
And that game really impressed me.
And he was in there the whole time and talking nonstop. Like, I was like, "You're a trooper, go!"
Next month, that's coming up.
Is it that soon?
Honestly, that's how a lot of the booths were, though. They were really jam packed.
Yeah. We got to meet 2K today, and that was amazing.
Yeah,
I did walk by one of the booths that was kind of empty.
Yeah,
in the indie booth area, that's a little odd. Yeah,
sorry.
No,
I walked by Z's turn actually.
Sorry.
No, I was trying to give him a turn.
I was just gonna say that it was empty, but there was one person playing the game. And I was like, there's no developer here. And it turns out, I walked by, I kind of came back and looked. The developer just gave up on talking to anybody. It was just turned around playing his own game. And I was like, that's kind of weird. But okay, moving on.
Maybe no one else was playing the game and he wanted to. Because he had probably on a bigger screen too, right?
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay, I was trying to justify for the guy.
That's unfortunate.
But like, I really didn't go into many of the big booths.
No.
Yeah. We went into the Borderlands.
Well, yeah, you went into the 2K stuff.
Well, yeah, only because you guys were like, "Let's go," and I'm right there. But
that was awesome.
It was. It was awesome.
The pre-sequel.
But would you have wanted to wait in that queue if we hadn't gotten to be Cheaty McCheatersons and slide in the back?
I don't think it's cheating. And we basically waited.
To flash a media badge is not cheating.
To quote somebody else, queue. Yeah.
wasn't someone saying that line was 6 hours long at the beginning of the day?
Yeah, Jesus.
The Borderlands one was?
Yeah.
Wow. They were giving away codes for the game, so there was a lot of people.
So people paid for packs to go stand in a line to get a game?
Their panel might have been a very long wait. Yeah. That's where they were giving away the game codes.
It could have been worse. It could have been in, like, the Watch Dogs and wait in line just to sign in on Facebook.
Ooh. Wait, what?
Just look. Yeah. Sorry, I'm getting sick. This sucks.
You're patient.
Are you still being here?
Yeah.
You might be sick.
I'm not sick. I'm good. I drank some orange juice.
Is that my alarm?
Oh, yes.
I'm going to go call a cab. Oh, God.
Oh. See you soon.
Bye.
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 Bye. I love you forever.
Do you seriously think they're going to be here within the next 30 minutes?
Oh, that's a good point.
Oh. That's awkward. Don't come back.
So you went and you signed in on Facebook?
Yeah, and it showed you, like, place. I don't know. It's something to do with, like, their weird little app that they had that for, like, the game and everything. But like, I just found it weird that you sign in on Facebook and everything. So now they have the information.
Yeah.
So that's cool. I wouldn't.
Facebook seems really involved in PAX this season. Like, it is signed to Facebook to use Twitch chat. I didn't even know that was possible to fucking integrate.
If you wanna, if you wanna chat in League of Legends streams, you have to sign it to Facebook too.
Really?
So it's not new. But like, I hate that. I've never commented on a. Fuck Facebook.
Yeah, no. Yeah. You tell me to sign a Facebook, I'm done with whatever you want to do. In fact, one of the media emails was like, you want to win an iPad mini or $1,000 or a card with our booth in here? Step one, sign a Facebook. I was like, no, I don't want any of those things anymore. Yeah, 2K, we never talk about 2K, but it was awesome. They, Paul's got to play Evolve.
Yeah, you guys went to go check out Borderlands, and me, Baj, Blue, and Biznap, and actually one of their sons there, we went in. And the son played as the monster, and we got to play as, like...
Well, it was cool, because we were standing there waiting for these guys to go to the
Should we explain what Evolved is? People probably haven't seen it.
It's...
Because the kid came up to you and was like, oh, you pause.
Yeah.
And then he was like, yeah, well, my dad works for 2K, and then it was like, he came in, and it was fantastic. Triggered his connections. Really well.
Yeah. They have connections now.
Well, they gave us, like, so much stuff.
Yeah, they gave us a lot of stuff.
Like, everything they were selling, t-shirts. Pretty much, they gave us for free. It was really amazing.
So, right, Evolved is...
Yeah, no one's going to explain it. Evolved is where there's four people who are hunters versus one person.
Wait, isn't it Evolved? Not Evolved?
Whatever. No, and one of them is playing this
it's good luck finding this game.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Is it Evolved?
I think it's just Evolved.
It's just Evolved.
Yeah.
But during the game, you
Evolve. Thanks.
And then when you're done, you have Evolved.
You're done with the game.
There's four players, one monster. The monster's also controlled by a human.
Say five players.
Yeah, well, I said four. Four hunt. Did I say four players?
Yeah, you said four players. And then
it's and like then the Ghostbusters versus like the State Puff
marshmallow. Fixed team.
That's a good analogy.
That's,
yeah.
That is good.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, the younger crowd will have no idea what you're talking about.
They've seen Ghostbusters.
No way.
No way. What?
Go watch. Pause this. Go. Not him.
No
Ghostbusters. Go watch Ghostbusters.
No Ghostbusters 2.
Then come back.
2?
No, not two.
One.
I don't
two.
Think they would.
Also,
I want everyone. If you're under the age of 15, say whether or not you've watched Ghostbusters.
Do it. Okay. Wait. Pause. Then go watch it. Then come back.
Yes.
And unpause.
Then unpause.
Now that you watch Ghostbusters.
So the Evolve looked kind of cool, but then we went over to the other part of the 2K booth, and we watched the Borderlands stuff.
It's called a pre-sequel, and that term confused me, and so I want to do a good job of explaining what that means. It's the timeline for it is in between
first and second.
So it's a prequel
to the sequel.
To the sequel.
Which has already come out.
Right.
It is its own game.
It is its own game. It's not DLC. It's its own game.
And it's like amazing. Borderlands 1.5.
Awesome. Yeah. Yeah, like they've added like ice damage. They have the people that make.
Are we allowed to talk about those things?
Yeah.
Yeah, they just said we couldn't take pictures and video.
Did you?
Low gravity.
No,
they said we can't.
I did not sign NDA.
You can say whatever the hell you want then.
Yeah.
It's set on the moon.
Penis.
On the moon of Pandora.
On the moon of Pandora, and there's zero gravity, which makes everything hilarious.
Not zero gravity.
Oh. I said low gravity.
No, you said zero.
You said zero.
There's video evidence.
Sorry.
Yeah. It is light.
But it looked good. They have different weapons. Although you do ground pound like Mario now.
That's awesome.
I think it's awesome.
This is ridiculous.
Like you do the butt stomp.
And the whole premise of Because
that's what you want to do when you're flying around in a spacesuit on the moon, is slam yourself into the ground.
It's Borderlands.
It's ridiculous.
Now that you mention it, yeah, I kind of do want to do that. Let's go to the moon, guys. Pandora.
The other game that I saw that I really liked was an indie game called Romance in a Difficult Space-Time.
Oh my god, that was so funny.
Basically, you're on a round ship that has all these armaments around it, and there's different stations on the ship.
Yeah. You and I tried that at PAX Prime, right?
Yeah. And
that was cool, yeah.
And stuff's coming from all sides, and you might have to run over and get on another gun to shoot something on the other side of the ship, and then someone might run over to the helm and drive the ship in a particular direction.
So it's a multiplayer game.
Yeah. Yeah.
But only two people.
Two people.
Okay.
And
multiplayer?
I believe it's
local.
Local. Local multiplayer.
That'd be awesome if it's online. Yeah.
But it was really cool. I like that one a lot.
Yeah. Paul's had a meeting with what's the name of it? Tiny Build?
Tiny Build.
Yeah. That was really good.
The guys who made Speedrunners, the game that me, Co, and Avidia always play.
What was the name of that that game that was like the RPG game.
I didn't get the name of that one, but I actually went there to check out one of their games that they're doing a Kickstarter for, Jeff Getters. And it was just like a sandbox little alpha, but it was a lot of fun. And everyone over there was pretty awesome, and we got to chat with them and exchange business cards. That was my first time, so that was beautiful.
The RPG was your first time is often...
Did you, should be beautiful.
Often
it's not.
And receive.
You gave and receive.
That's a lot.
That was professional.
Wow. Nice.
And the RPG was kind of cool. It was like a Japanese RPG, but then like arrows would come on the screen. And you had to move your cursor over the arrows, and how well you did determined how solid your hit was.
Like if you had to do a Z snap.
Yes.
Oh, sure.
Now he knows exactly what it is.
I missed the first snap, but that's okay.
No.
Have you ever seen this?
Have you seen In Living Color? You don't do the first one.
Wait, so you knew all this fucking time?
You have to do a Z-snap better than everyone?
You've been schooled.
I may have been role-playing a little. I don't know.
Who is this guy?
You did it
earlier.
So...
he like created the G-snap. Or wait, that was not a G.
That was not a G.
Yeah, it's
and then we had the dots, too.
No, you did the dots.
Oh,
you
right.
did them in a Z pattern.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Right. Like, on the panel, you did it like a really pathetic one. You're like...
I wanted to pretend like I was very upset about that question.
Oh.
Turns out you loved
pretending.
It.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. Oh, now you can move your head too.
Girl, you sassy.
Oh my.
What did we do the first day?
Yeah, I was just trying to. $40 stakes. God, that was so long ago.
I meant the first day of PAX, but yeah, the first day here, yeah, we went and had steaks at Blue Ox.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it was so
good. A shaved prosciutto salad that was delicious.
Yeah, that place.
And then we had porcini crusted bone-in ribeyes.
He's about to absolutely lose it.
With an herb butter and what's duck fat duck fat potatoes and roasted asparagus.
So good.
Where were you? Fucking assholes.
Yeah, it was pretty much the best thing.
Hey, you know what? You were sleeping for 5 hours. I come here.
Wake me up.
Oh,
right. You were sleeping.
You were sleeping.
Come say something.
We didn't want to.
No one knew where you were.
He knew.
You could have told him.
He knew. You didn't know. He knew.
Could you confirm you'd like to eat?
That's when we turned up and we rang the doorbell. There was nobody here.
Just walked in.
Yeah, the door was open. We walked in. Nobody here. Laptops out. TV on.
Yeah, nobody was here.
You could have robbed
except
us.
Except for Z. Apparently, Z was here the entire time.
We went all around the house looking for people and we were shouting, hello.
I think you found the secret compartment. We could have been robbed.
He's Batman. He was disappearing.
Right. I was hanging from the rafters.
I think the best thing is that you went to our refrigerator and tweeted out pictures of our sausage.
Wait.
It's like alcohol, coke, sausage.
Yeah. It was a lot of sausage.
It was a lot of sausage. Oh,
it's good, though.
In the fridge, too. You could call it a sausage
party. We like
party.
Big sausage here.
I don't know. The only time I've ever seen something like that is dog food.
What?
Go on.
In the UK, the big fat sausages like that are dog food.
This is another one of those, like, they just call it a different thing.
Maybe we were eating
it. Oh, so it's not even dog food. It's not
it's like a cue. Food for dogs.
Oh.
Yeah. That's dog food.
What does dogs mean in Britain?
Canines.
And then, let's keep talking about food. So then the next night.
After that, I drank a margarita.
Then we went to, the next night we had a dinner with FTB.
Yes.
Uh-huh. That was Plus.
Okay. Which is a, which stands
it's not
for
recording.
Feed the Beast.
I bet it's not recording.
It's not recording.
I was very concerned.
It shut off somehow.
I fucking knew it.
This
we
is recording.
Knew
this
it.
Is recording.
What?
So it's okay.
Okay. All right.
So we no longer have a video podcast?
I don't know why I was not recording.
I'm just saying, we're all going to give you shit forever.
You know, if we had a light.
I didn't fucking design this camera. It's not my fault.
Why didn't you buy a camera without a light on the front?
Step one, does camera have light on front?
Pretty much.
I don't go.
So did any of it record?
I don't know how much.
Pause, please!
Can you start recording again?
It's recording right now!
So that means
that's still
none of it
on, don't worry,
recorded.
We still got audio.
I know we still have audio.
Are we
just wondering how much video
we're gonna.
Lost.
Yeah, I guess so. Hello?
Alright, let's start over. Welcome to the Minecraft podcast.
Right.
Taking my job from back. Me?
Oh, sorry.
I'll just stand over here. I'll continue to watch.
Yeah. So we went and we had dinner with Feed the Beast.
When was that?
Because Friday.
The first two nights ago.
First day of PAX.
Oh, yeah. That was the first day of PAX. Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah. That place was shit. Every fucking time. Fuck you, Slowpoke. I'm gonna let you know. Hope you watch. Every fucking time you take me somewhere to eat, it's shit.
So you didn't like the food either.
No, that place was shit.
Because I sent my steak back twice.
Yes.
Wow. And didn't even eat.
The third time it was awful.
Yeah, well, it was actually, I think it was just the second time, but it just took so long to
bring
it back.
What was wrong with it each time?
It was the first time it was.
I overcooked it every time.
I ordered it medium rare and it came like black on the inside. And I was like, okay, I'm a big steak guy. No. Send it back. I don't usually send back my food. I'm ordering this. Cook it right, please. Oh, so he brings it out on a skillet, like a fajita skillet. It's still going.
Yeah, she slides it around like.
And she puts it on.
Yeah, it makes the whole room stink.
Yeah, and she puts it on my plate, and I'm like, that was kind of an interesting way to do this, but and she's like,
cut into it.
Yeah, cut into it first before I go away, so I know it's cooked right. And I was like, okay, and I kind of waited because I knew it. That steak needs to rest.
Right.
So like, no, before I walk away, cut into it. So I cut into it a little bit. I'm like, no, it looks great. Which it did at the time. It cooked for another 30 seconds on the plate, and all of a sudden I cut into it again, and it...
Well, not only that, all the fucking juices ran out. If you cut into the steak before it's rested, it's
horrible.
Yeah.
It's horrible.
Oh, my God.
And Good and I were like, well, what's safe? What do you think's safe? And we're both like, ribs? We can do ribs. Ribs sound good.
Ribs
are terrible.
What? Ribs are not safe.
Ribs are usually pretty good bet.
No.
Are you serious?
I would say I don't know.
No, I would disagree with that completely.
Ribs take more attention than anything else in most restaurants.
Yeah, but when you're going with pub food.
If you want quality, I'm going to get on my soapbox a little bit here. Yeah. But it takes like 7 or 8 hours of special attention to make ribs right.
And this is coming from a guy who eats a dry mutton chop sitting in his living room for...
I didn't know that the restaurant was shit when I was ordering my food, so I didn't know that it was going to be... I don't know, I got ribs and chicken, and my chicken was burnt, too.
I got mac and cheese. I'm happy with what I got. That's fucking simple. You can't fuck up mac and cheese.
The mac and cheese was good. I got it as a side.
Nice.
The beer was delicious. It's a brewery.
Yeah, the beer.
Was great.
Yeah.
Last year at PAX East, Slowpoke took me to a place called Kinsale's, and the food was absolute shit. And so today he texts me like, hey, we're all going out to eat. We're going to Kinsale's. You want to come? I was like, no, that place was fucking shit.
Yeah.
So Wes found us a place that was awesome. What the fuck was it called?
Dolce Vita.
Tonight?
Oh yeah, that's where you got to stay. It was an Italian place that you got to stay at, so it's not their. I'm not saying it should be bad, but it's not their primary like.
You're literally the only person out of 42 people that complained about their food.
I think he's the only person that got to stay. Probably.
No.
No.
You didn't like it.
I don't know.
I was not impressed. Not for really? The money, no. No, I was not impressed.
It was not cheap.
Before the beer turned up, he's like, oh, sorry, I forgot it, you know.
Yeah, you're waiting like 40 minutes for your sandwich.
Well, we did order a cheese platter that took... You came in after us and ordered fucking whatever your...
Yeah, you ordered your bread cheese.
Bread. It
was just garlic and bread.
No, we ordered cheese when we first got there.
Here's what happened with that though. We ordered it when we first got there. Like a half hour later, it still hadn't come. We were like, hey, so is the cheese platter coming? And he's like, oh yeah, it's coming out. And then like
he ran 30 from
seconds
the table.
Later, he goes in and like,
I mean,
pulls
they had to milk the cheese platter. They had to milk the cows. You know, it just takes a while.
They forgot.
Well, all the bread, obviously. The bread rolls that came out was all down the other end of the table. We had to keep getting Jeff to pass them down.
Yeah. Well, what do you think of like packed? They get made at restaurants like this about sharing food and such.
That was a wonderful transition, Vintage Beef.
Wow. I love PAX. I'm excited about PAX South, yeah.
Yeah, we had the P-PAX. That was the
PAX South sounds awesome. I can't wait to go.
The P-PAX was the first PAX
right,
of the weekend, right?
Okay. We need to frame this. So Seth has been making PAX with everyone about...
Oh, are we saying PAX or PAX?
No.
I was specifically looking at you two based on the restaurant about the food.
The food PAX.
The sharing of the food.
So here's the thing.
You betrayed me.
Incoming excuse.
Oh, this is recording.
3, 2, 1.
After the shit you pulled at that panel.
I'm
going to
get my camera.
What shit?
What?
It was comedy relief.
Mine was too. Breaking the pact. It was
sure it was.
Comedy relief.
We had one pact went off flawlessly. It was, it doesn't matter what the pact
that
was.
That one was important.
Yeah, that was a good pact. Doesn't matter what it was.
We weren't gonna,
no. Yeah, okay. We had a second. It might have been a P-pact in a crowded car.
Yeah.
But doesn't matter. We had a
second. Not to pee.
I don't know.
Not to pee.
Not to pee together or anything.
What? Yeah.
That's wow. We're just.
I'm just saying. I'm just.
Like, you might want to explain it because
you had a P-pact. Like, what are you gonna do with a P-pact? Like,
they hold each other's hands.
Yeah, that's right. Like, that's an obvious assumption.
We shared a urinal.
Yeah. But then, they shared a moment.
That was the most awkward silence.
There's some awkward
silence. Well, it's in their bedroom.
Yeah.
I'm actually glad the food pact went to shit because as a result, I got to enter the food pact. And
yeah, so we had a food pact to trade food.
Well, there was a second pact, actually.
What was the second pact?
Drew doesn't know about the second pact.
Oh, that's right.
This was an important pact. The second pact was if we were going to vomit.
If we got too drunk.
Too drunk. And
oh, yeah, vomit, last night.
It was
going to
be on
we were going to vomit on
so
Goop.
So that was the first
I would have literally punched you in the face because I made a promise to myself to do that.
He made his own pact.
I got my own pact.
He made the punching puke pact.
Yes. So.
There were a lot of packs.
But we fulfilled that pact as well.
We did. Yes. Because neither of us puked.
Neither of us did, yes.
Right.
And then the third pact was when we got to dinner, you ordered veal, I ordered calamari, and we were going to trade. We were gonna share.
They took so long to bring Zisto's food. By the time they brought it out,
the moment they brought it out,
I was taking the last bite of my food. I'm sorry, Zisto.
You broke the pact.
I broke the pact. What can I do?
I have to
make it up to you.
So just going back, how was anyone thinking about my food?
Willing to do a lot.
Half an hour.
Oh my god. It may not on camera.
That's true. Good point.
Don't even find his room. That is
the Badger song. Right now.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh. You said anything. I said anything. It's on.
I thought this meant a lot to you.
Nah.
Not really.
I mean, I'd like to go like fix you a drink or something.
Oh, I'd like a drink.
Okay.
Yeah.
While singing the bad.
I do. I have to admit that the look on Seth's face, because the second he finished that bite of food, they literally dropped off Zisto's food.
You don't have to.
And he just goes, "You betrayed me," and he goes. It was like the most tear in the
head. And then he put his hands in.
Yes.
He did this for like 3 minutes.
It was a moment of shame.
Did you?
I'm glad it happened. As a result, I got to enter the pack.
Yeah,
so I got some calamari.
You remember, and you were just watching him eat, knowing he was going to break it so that you could get him later.
Were you really?
Yes.
Awesome.
Oh my god.
The Twitch Minecraft.
So this is where the ships have fallen, I see.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
That's what we did the first day.
Yeah, the Twitch set up a party at King's, and we went, and everybody got t-shirts.
Oh my god.
Nice t-shirts.
Except for you.
Aren't you wearing it?
I know.
No.
Don't rub it in.
I'm not wearing anything.
Oh.
What?
My x-ray vision is like on reverse or something.
I don't know.
My brain is mentally dressing him right now.
I think the most important part about that party was that there was free skee ball.
Yeah.
It was just amazing.
Well, I played shuffleboard.
Yeah, I was going to say, I taught you guys shuffleboard.
That was cool too.
The pizza was pretty
shuffleboard?
Good too.
That's not real shuffleboard. No, shuffleboard, you have
it's
a.
No, it's not old people floored on retired
shuffleboard.
That was not shuffleboard.
You're supposed to know this shuffleboard before you know this shuffleboard.
Really? No.
It's a progression of ages. This is for old people who are retired.
That's really what it's for.
I played that when I was a kid. I have yet to try the big old shuffleboard.
You're missing out.
I will actually admit that.
I
played the other one first, actually. It was with my grandparents in Florida.
You mean.
Yes.
I've never seen in a bar or anything
good
one of those tables.
No, it exists
in crappy motels along the beach in Florida.
Where everyone's retired.
They exist in a lot of bars for expensive prices. Like, a lot of them are very expensive, like 15 or 20 bucks an hour. I happen to grow up in a very bad town, I guess. It's a place, there's a lot of bars, a lot of alcohol, a lot of sports bars. And a lot of sports bars will have big pool halls. And the one I happen to go to all the time, we have free darts, free shuffleboard, and very cheap pool. So I got very well introduced to bar games.
It's more like curling without the curling.
Yeah. Without the, is that what it's called? Is it actually called curling?
It's not curling.
It's like wood
but like with play not curling.
But is the part of curling that's called curling this part? Is that what curling is? Yes.
Yeah. Which part of
from this angle all I can see is this.
So anyways. No, but if you say it's curling without curling, I mean you
without
all the
brushing.
Without brushing. Without so brushing. That's what I was asking. What part? Yeah. What is curling? Part? What
I mean, is the curling is like curling the curl of the path, right? No. We have a Canadian here. Why are we even speculating?
Don't you learn this in elementary school?
I fucking tell hate us, that Paul. Sport. I don't know anything about it. Why that's our national sport with hockey? I have no idea.
Is it really?
Yeah.
With hockey? What do you mean?
Wow, that's depressing.
In addition to?
You don't go curling while you play hockey.
Is that what you mean?
No, you play hockey and curling at the same time.
At the same time.
Hockey curling.
Is that like extreme hockey?
Yeah, no, it's curling.
It's big of a fuck that you
shoot. That's definitely the less extreme hockey.
Can you imagine picking one of those things up and hitting someone in the face with that bit of air?
That would be more extreme hockey.
But Ari was there.
Ari organized the entire thing. Aurelia, if you don't know who she is.
And we got drinks.
Chad and I played the world's longest game of pool.
Yeah, we found out that we're both really crappy. And it lasted for a long time.
There's one thing I said about last year. We went to the same place, and I ordered. I don't know if you guys seen it, but the big fishbowl. Last year I was able to drink it alone. This year I bought one, and she's like, legally you have to drink that with another person, and I got
really
disappointed. Yeah,
you did two of them alone last year. That. Why do you need another person to drink a drink?
Because there's so much alcohol
in it. Whatever, I probably drink like six of them.
It classifies you as publicly intoxicated from consuming that one beverage.
But if I can buy a pitcher on my own, is that not that I didn't,
no,
but
I have before. In my experience, you can. Yeah. You need to get cups with the pitcher.
Really? I've definitely gone to places and been like, hey, I need a pitcher.
You go to bars and order pitchers just to drink by yourself?
I have before. If I go to bars to get a pitcher, sometimes people are drinking liquor drinks and I don't want liquor.
But how many cups?
You're with other people.
I've gone to a bar by myself before and had a pitcher, yes. But
how many cups of beer are in a pitcher? About five?
Yeah, okay. About.
Do you think, how many shots of liquor do you think she'd put in that thing?
About five. Paint stripper, man, that was...
I mean, yeah, she would take three things and kind of like, for a while.
It was delicious.
It was quite delicious.
So I think there's a...
But what were they shots of? Like, very fruity-ish.
No!
Probably rum. Probably, I mean, it was probably rum.
I mean, there was some rum, vodka, and amaretto, right?
Amaretto,
very small.
But there's one other.
Yeah, well, that's 20%.
There's a lot of amaretto in
that. Yeah, 20%.
I could taste the amaretto in that.
It's higher than I thought, but
still lower, like around 40%.
Yeah.
And then we went...
And
what
did we go after there?
Then we went to FTB dinner, and that's when
the ship food.
And that's when Curse tweeted out that they bought us.
People are still tweeting me asking when I'm gonna put out a video that explains the details of the Curse buyout. Like there are tons of people who do not know this is a joke.
So what happened was Donovan jokingly tweeted out that Curse bought Mindcrack, and then Slowpoke confirmed it. And Sasha Varel was on Twitter.
You retweeted it.
I did retweet it. It's my fault. I thought it was funny.
It was.
I didn't think it was.
It's not plausible.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I didn't. But I'm an idiot because I should have known that people believe everything. I mean, that's how April Fool's actually still works on YouTube. So
I mean, should have known. Can we be honest now and tell them that we bought Cursed?
Yeah, that's. In fact, we renamed them to Cursed. They're no longer Cursed.
Sorry,
they're now Cursed.
Sorry.
And the only game
we
can play now on our channels though is Evolved. Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Nice. After we've done playing it.
But it got so bad, Sasha Varel believed it so much he put it on the front page.
It showed up on the front page of the Minecraft forums, and it really looked real.
Yeah.
We took it down pretty quickly.
Well, yeah, because then at the moment that happened, I looked slow, and I was like, this is kind of not funny anymore.
Minecraft or Mindcrack?
Minecrafted.
So the Minecraft forum.
Minecraft forums.
Oh, yeah.
The big one.
Yeah.
The big one.
Yeah.
The big one.
Yeah. Well, because he like Sasha Varel tweeted or DM'd Slowpoke and asked for details, and he gave him like this whole list of details. Like they've got the no exclusive rights to the name and the logo, and we've joined forces with Feed the Beast and blah blah blah.
Properly.
That's funny.
Yeah, he's like he's like, yeah. It's like wow, Slow, you've really. Did it. He controlled the shit out of him. I think it's funny in you know, in hindsight. But
it is funny.
It's crazy.
It's a funny joke.
It is.
So then, we decided, everybody's like, we gotta go to bed. We stayed up too late last night.
No, no, no.
And I said, no. I said, no. And I said, Chad, you can't go home in particular.
You dragged me along.
Because you are my wingman.
Oh my god.
And then I managed to talk Zisto and Paws into joining me.
I required no talking.
I don't remember that.
I was all for it.
No, yeah, he was all for it. I
okay,
remember that.
Okay.
I mean, Paws was worried because he didn't have a dress shirt. He was supposed to, they were going to a party where it had a dress code that apparently no one enforced. So I actually gave Paws my shirt to wear.
Yeah.
Which he complained about how much it stank the whole time.
Did he really?
Yeah, he did. Yeah. He said, it smells like good. It died.
It does not
stink. Wait, that doesn't mean it stinks? What the fuck does that mean? You said it stink?
Not me. It was Paws.
It smells like goo. Does it mean it stinks, asshole?
I didn't say stink ever.
They did, and you confirmed it by saying, it smells like goo.
Yeah, it smells like goo.
He said it smelled. He didn't say whether it smelled good or bad.
He smelled bad. He said
it smelled bad.
I was interpreting what he said. But you'll have to ask him.
Paws.
You always stink.
If you weren't sick, I'd touch you.
No, maybe you just said it smelled
like
where would you touch him?
So we didn't know whether we were even going to be able to get in. Like, we did.
The club had the dress code.
Right. The club had the dress code.
This was the VIP dress party.
It was no, it was no jeans. It was no jeans, no sneakers.
Which we all had.
And a collared shirt and no hoodies. And we were mostly we were all in jeans. Most of us had sneakers. I didn't.
Except for you.
And then Paws had put on Goode's ratty looking shirt that he was wearing.
It was terrible.
And stinky.
And it was smelly. I will never do anything for you ever again.
Dude, the whole club was like, dude, this fucking stinks like Goode.
Huh?
The card's full.
The card is full.
Oh, I was going to say. Hold on before we start. We
all have to hug Sev.
I'm leaving in 5 minutes.
Then let's hug you.
So.
Is this
bye.
Are you leaving?
Weren't you saying?
I'm leaving. I might be. Yeah.
Okay, well, so that's part
of it.
Okay.
I'm so excited to get to know you this trip.
Ditto.
Oh. Cool.
I will do so.
Are you already recording for us?
Hey, man.
Yeah. Recording the mothers.
I came over here.
You mean you meant?
Yeah.
We're giving Sev hugs. Sev hugs.
I don't want to give you a hug.
Because you're sick. Yeah.
Yeah, that's now a 32 gigabyte card, so that shouldn't fill up. Okay. I did on the 16 before.
You sure? Tablet or not, but like, wow. Good thing, man. Just couldn't use a phone line.
Definitely try to look at
it. Couldn't do it. I could not.
It's way too big
for me. I
hate this card.
I'm perfectly happy with my iPhone. Honestly, my iPhone
could send that much.
I don't know what I would do.
No, they wouldn't do it.
You'll get used to it.
I guess I'll have to.
And then you'd be like, yeah, never use that.
Well, hey, I think you're always going to have the size you have now.
Awesome.
Why? All
right.
I mean,
there's so many people use it.
Yeah,
so it'd be stupid.
Because if they go larger, every app.
Welcome back!
Technical difficulties.
We apologize.
Where were we?
I was telling the story.
Edit that out. Pause.
And pause.
Yeah. Oh my god. Yeah. Please edit out what I just said before. I mean, then we'll mask it as a technical difficulty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because that got
Can
racist.
You do the clock?
So, I was talking about the Twitch party.
We already got one bad chew. We don't need a fucking second one chewing.
Would you like some bad?
You are so professional.
Where's your fucking nerds? Where's your nerds?
Oh yeah, the nerds.
You're saying you don't want two badges.
Oh my god!
I told you.
Are there two badges?
I do not see them all night. As soon as the fucking podcast starts out, he puts the nerds aside. I'm like, what the fuck? This guy's like,
I put them down so I almost needed them.
You should do that during our regular podcast too.
So, the Twitch party, the cars were against us. We didn't have dress code. We didn't know where it was. We weren't on the VIP list.
And then, even funnier is, I had struggled to find some parking.
Yeah.
And then we get back to the car to drive to the party, and I've gotten a parking ticket.
Right. And we're like, oh, that really sucks. Well, I guess let's go pile in this car and figure out where the hell this party is. Get in the car, we make it a block, and find out.
It took us like this weird route where we actually went away for a bit and then came back.
Well, I think we just started, you were like, where is it? Like, you just started driving.
Yeah, yeah. I just started going in a direction. Yeah, you guys were going, and I just started driving in a direction. I'm like, give me directions on where we're going. I started heading back towards, where we had been.
Yeah, everything had been. And you find out it's literally a block and a half from where we had just eaten food. Like, not even like a full city block, like a half, like crappy block.
To be fair, Blue Hag told you it was just around the corner.
We had not really. We had not
really. I haven't heard that.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no, she did say that several times.
To who?
Yeah.
To a wall.
Talking to you guys is like a wall.
So we try to pull back around to where we had gotten the ticket because I figured
we have the ticket,
I'll park in the same spot and then we'll just put the ticket back on the windshield.
Fortunately, there's a cop there, so we
can really pull in, and there's a cop right there. And so we kind of pull in the spot, and he kind of looks right at us. Like, he's outside of his car writing things, and he just looks right at us. And we're like, we can't get out and like slide this under the thing. It's like, hey, we're fine. We got a permit.
So we go and park in a really expensive parking deck, and I'm trying to get us all pumped because everybody's like, we're not getting in because we're not on the VIP, we're not dressed anyway.
And we were on the phone with them telling them, you're not getting in.
And we tried calling people. We're like,
we're trying to use contacts to get in.
Yeah. So we get up, and I decide, look, let's just play dumb. Let's assume that we're supposed to get in and see what happens.
We also got to mention that at the very first like Minecraft one, like the Minecraft Twitch party, we got wristbands.
Yes.
Twitch partner
that says Twitch partner.
Yeah, we
can
got
you make
these.
Make sure that's recording.
Pause.
It's flashing.
Okay, good.
Anyway, so we got these wristbands. And so what I did was I just walked up and I said, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. We're Twitch partners. Where are we supposed to go?
Yeah, Twitch partners, let us in, please.
Yeah.
Twitch partners.
And there were two lines in the front. There was one really, really long one and one that was about four people long.
Right.
And they're like, oh, you've got wristbands? Get in the short line.
And we immediately like scope out the other wristbands, completely different color. Not we have at all.
Right. And then like other VIPs walk up, people we know from YouTube, and are like, I'm so-and-so, I'm on the VIP list, and they're like, go get in the VIP line, the long line. So we're in this really short line, all these famous people are in the really long line, and we get let right in.
Yeah, we weren't standing there for longer than 5 minutes.
Right,
yeah.
But I turn around, and I'm looking, and like, Paz is standing there in a shirt that's a little too small for him. In sneakers and jeans.
Your shirt was a bit small, so it's cut off up here, so I was like, this is not gonna fucking work. I'm just like, really uncomfortable.
When you had to put it up to the buttons, kind of stretched a little bit.
Yeah, it stretched a little bit, but they didn't say a thing. They let him right in.
Yeah.
But then
we get to the second
level. Wait, hold on, and we're going down the stairs.
Chill out.
It's not your turn.
But we were so proud of ourselves going down the stairs. We're going down into there.
Yeah, we're like, we made it.
Yes, we're in. And then
high fives all around.
Exactly, and then we get to the bottom, and there's a woman there, and she's like, okay, what are your names again?
No, we pull up and she's like, well, you need the wristband. And we're like, we got the wristband.
No, the guy tells us.
And she's like, wrong wristband.
No.
Like, that is not the right wristband.
You need an orange
wristband. And we're like, no, the gig's up. So, he's like, go over that line.
It wasn't that easy because, like, we had to go, it was divided. There was, like, a rope. So
right.
The guy told us to go over there. And then he's like, yeah, I'm Wes Wilson. We're part of the Minecraft Network. And then she asked me, I'm like, yeah, I'm with him. She's like, how many people are in your party? These two as well.
Four. So, right. Yeah. So she's like, so your name's on the list, right? And of course we're like,
yes.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, we're with Minecraft.
I'm like,
yeah.
We're Twitch partners. And I just kept going, we're Twitch partners.
Twitch partners.
And
it worked.
Yes.
She's like, oh, Twitch partners, I'm not even gonna look at my list. Go grab, like, this guy, get them wristbands now.
And so we get another wristband slapped on us and we get let in and we're like,
yeah.
Also, when we were at the dinner, I tried to take my wristband off because I hate wristbands. So there's like a little strip of plastic left.
His was all mangled and chewed on.
In the party, I just go like this and it breaks. I'm like, holy shit.
So anyway, we got into the party and then we walk up to the bar and it was an open bar.
Open bar, cool DJ.
Yeah, it was
in
a great time.
In case anyone is confused as what open bar means, it means free.
Free. And we're not talking well free. We're not talking...
Yeah, they wouldn't do anything.
No, I was drinking Makers and Coke.
Yep. Yeah, it was pretty nice.
And there was great people there.
How was the scotch?
They did not have any good scotch at all.
Really?
Bar sucked.
Yeah, it fucking sucked.
Yeah, I mean, it was really the whole experience.
Gassy Mexican and Renee were there.
Captain Jordan and Ari were there.
Captain Jordan, is that what you said?
Captain Jordan.
It was a lot of fun. And the DJ was having a good time, playing music, and yeah.
Actually, that's going to that party is how we actually got introduced to approaching Nirvana.
Oh, yeah.
Aurelian told me that they were looking at for a place to...
So without us having taken the initiative to go to that party.
Yeah.
And then I text Good, and then I never got a response. I text Sav, and I didn't get a response either.
Do you want to talk about the text that he sent you?
Oh, yeah. Not sure if you've heard of this. Fuck, what's my fault? No, I don't have it.
Can you confirm if you know this?
Sure. Now, now you don't have your phone.
Sorry.
Yeah, right.
I don't know if you know everyone.
Sorry.
Yeah. I was just like, I don't know if you guys know this group.
There's this fairly popular band called Approaching Nirvana. I'm not sure if you're familiar with them, but they like to come to our house and play. What do you think? It was like, yeah.
No, I never said they want to come. I said they're looking for a place.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And it's, okay. See if you
yeah, but it was kind of funny because like earlier that day, like it was more funny for Sev because earlier that day he'd spent a lot of time talking to them and he was like, yeah, Paul was there when I was fucking talking to him.
Well, not sure if you're familiar. Sir did. I didn't know
no,
you did.
No, you sent the same text.
Well, I was just making sure.
We met them in the parking lot, the overflow parking lot, randomly, and they were going to the Twitch party, found out we were going to the Twitch party, and so I was like, oh yeah, you can just follow us, we're going to head there right now, and
they started
talking, and all of a sudden he was like, wait, oh, you're approaching Nirvana. Like, so we had already been talking from PAX and up to the Twitch party.
By the way, never drive with BTC. These guys get to places like 20 minutes faster, and then we show up late.
Well, at least you weren't taking a bloody train everywhere.
That is true.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Trains.
The trains.
What's the difference between being nice and letting Fedrin have the spare seat in your car?
I didn't know. I thought you guys were driving. I didn't know.
Well, I'm kind of sad about the Twitch party, but I was way too... tired.
It was pretty freaking awesome. It was the best party
there's
I've ever been to.
There's strippers.
The best party ever until the party that was had at the crack house.
The Coke was cut with Coke. It was so good.
Coke was cut with Coke. Holy crap.
It had been stepped on -1 times.
Stepped on?
That was a joke. There was no drugs. Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah. If you're under...
Whatever done to drugs.
If you haven't seen Ghostbusters,
what's
they're under
legal age. Cocaine.
Like, if you're under the legal age for cocaine,
where are you going with this?
Pause the video and try some cocaine.
I want a disclaimer. Thank you for the disclaimer.
I'm going to jail. Right?
Is this illegal in Seattle?
Not for long.
It's legal where I come from. I don't really
know. At least I fly them from Cuba for our pals.
Yeah.
What else happened?
Everything.
Did we even go to PAX that day? I don't remember going to PAX that day. I have no fucking memory of the first day of PAX.
We went.
Yeah, we went.
We took Betty there today.
Today was a very stressful day, actually.
What? Today felt like Minecon. It felt like Minecon. You couldn't move without...
Really stressed about the 2K thing. Like, at the end, I was like, it's just Borderlands. Like, you were just like, we've been here for 2 hours, not moving.
I was trying to get something happening, weren't you?
Yeah. The only time I ran into fans was I was watching, they had a Street Fighter tournament. And I was watching it. I was, like, so excited to see a tournament in person. Because, like, whatever. I like watching... Fighting game tournaments.
Yeah, okay,
I'm sorry. I play video games on the internet. I'm a nerd. I'm sorry.
Watch some kids play the game.
So I was very excited to see a tournament in person. I'm sitting there tweeting about it in person. And as soon as the tournament ends, I turn around and there's like this crowd of people like sitting there waiting to like
they were kind enough to not bother you while you were enjoying the tournament.
That's what really impressed me, cool. That people were patient enough to wait for it to end.
That's awesome. I just wish I had been able to see it from like a...
Yeah, I turned around and like, oh, hi, how long have you been waiting?
People have been pretty good, I think.
Yeah.
People are always awesome. They always are. Like, it was kind of funny. The first day, there was this guy. He came up to us when we first got there. This is the only thing I remember from the first day, apparently. Oh, wait, no, this was the second day. Apparently, I have no memory of the first day. Second day, he came up to us. He was like, you could tell he was really timid and scared and everything. Yeah. By the time our panel was done, he was cracking jokes.
Little
redheaded guy.
He was ordering us around.
Yeah.
He was like, you go here, you go here. I'm gonna take a photo. You go this, do this.
Yeah, it's great.
I know why you don't remember the first day.
Because the first night I didn't go to bed till 6 a.m. and I drank a ton.
Yeah,
this is the guy who's like, you know what? I don't need to set an alarm. The sun will wake me up. I always wake up and the sun fucking sleeps in until like 10 or 11.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, your alarm goes off. And
I set an alarm. Apparently it went off for a while. Apparently BGC threw a pillow at me. I don't know.
He was very determined that somebody sabotaged him and kept turning his alarm off.
I was upset about
him. It was him.
I didn't turn my alarm off.
I don't think anybody
did. No, BGC said he went to my room and turned my alarm off.
And didn't wake him up.
No, didn't wake me up. Just like, oh, what's this noise? Let me cut this off and fuck off now.
Should we mention that he was sleeping on an entirely different floor?
Right, he came up from the floor downstairs.
He did like come in several times and tell you to turn off your alarm.
Oh, really?
Apparently, that's what he says. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So, I mean, obviously, I slept through the alarm. I was obviously dead to the world. So, and he did throw a pillow. I woke up and there was a pillow on my head, and I was like,
I think the problem.
What the fuck?
The problem is you didn't go to sleep until the sun had already risen.
Yeah. Honestly, that is probably the problem. The sun was already up.
Yep.
You know what really sucks? I was up at 7 waiting for this guy to get up, and I could have friggin' slept and actually be rested. I slept for 3 hours that night.
Oh, yeah, because we all made a pact. to go, well, some...
And you wouldn't break a pact, would you?
Well, a lot of us had media badges.
There was no pact.
Go in early.
I missed it, because you got that cool Wolfenstein bag. In fact, today we tried to go play Wolfenstein, and we tried to use our media badge, and they were like, we're not honoring media badges today, and I was like, okay, I won't promote your game then, thanks.
Are they rebooting that again?
Yeah. I don't know.
Here you are talking about it on the podcast.
Don't play it.
Play it. Best swag.
No, it's probably good though.
Best swag of the.
Did you play it?
Yeah.
Was it good?
Well, it was controller, so it's.
All right. We played Sniper Elite with a controller too. Oh, there's a video with that.
So off of bags.
In the new Wolfenstein, do you get to fight Hitler, and does he have 4 Gatling guns? Like in the original.
Right. Is there still like tons
there's
of
There's some big stuff? Ass giant robot walking around on the battlefield, you know, running around in trenches.
Does he have the mustache?
There's electric.
Did you play the one when it came back and it was just called Wolfenstein?
No, I just played the old one.
It was legitimately good.
Yeah, yeah. Return to Wolfenstein was good.
Yeah.
I think it's
a really good IP. It's got.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Killing Nazis will never get old.
Nazis and, right. You know, cult and...
Killing BTC.
Robots is great. Isn't
it? What was the second Wolfenstein? It wasn't Wolfenstein, but it was the...
It was Wolfenstein 3D.
Something of Destiny.
Oh. Spear of Destiny.
Spear of Destiny, yeah. That's right. That was like the same game mechanics, but you were
just a new levels and stuff, basically. And
but it wasn't Nazis anymore.
Right. Well, it's because the Nazis were working to... raise like that's the whole Wolfenstein. That's a big part of Wolfenstein, that there's all this lore about the Nazis trying to raise demons and raise the dead and stuff.
So interested.
What the fuck? Anyways. Yeah, yeah. Well, now I don't know even what I was saying anymore. I thought we were gonna make out or something. Oh god.
The battery's running out because of like all the wasted time and everything.
Yeah,
we need to wind down.
Yeah, we probably should wind down. It's been like 2 hours, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so PAX has been great.
Maybe this will be a two-parter.
Okay, questions?
Maybe.
Questions from the audience?
Well, apparently the audience has fallen asleep.
That's terrible.
That's too bad.
No questions.
Did Sev leave?
Sev is gone.
This is such a sad
Jesus,
moment.
This is so sad.
Right?
Fuck.
I need to comfort myself. Here, I'll get some ice cubes.
If you guys aren't familiar with people that aren't part of Minecraft, this is OMG Chad.
Hello.
He works for Twit.
Yep.
Twit, not Twitch.
What's your YouTube?
Yeah. YouTube.com/OMGChad.
What's your Twitter?
OMGChad.
And if you're not familiar, you're probably going to see him a lot more on this channel because he's going to be doing the weekly recap very soon. He presented a pilot and those that watch it really liked it.
And he has red hair.
And he has red hair, and that's pretty much...
And he's really useful to have at PAX.
Does your hair change with the season?
No. I've had this only this shade.
So, it doesn't go from, like, yellow to orange to red to brown, and then the green.
Dude, you should do something in fall.
No.
And just fall. You should do, like, a fall moment.
I would have to change all of my avatar.
Oh, what?
And if it changed it to a more muted color, he'd just be, meh, Chad.
Yeah.
Chad. Wow. What? And the guy at the end?
Obviously,
this is Wes Wilson, and he's project coordinator for Minecraft, so if you didn't know that already, now you know.
Dun, dun, dun. He bans the fools.
I gotta show this, because I think...
He's got the ban hammer.
Yeah, I have some friends at Fun to 11 Games, and they made a game called Flame War, where you're trying to make forum threads, and you can pull out the ban hammer. Since I've been doing bans on Play Minecraft, they gave me one of these...
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
What actually is that?
Huh?
Is it a cape?
It's a jersey.
It's a really big jersey.
Cloak. And their game is called Fun to... Their company's called Fun to 11. It goes to 11.
Oh.
Cool.
Old people jokes.
Old people there.
Well, thank you guys for watching. We apologize for the technical difficulties.
I'll pretend I didn't get the joke.
I'm sorry, pause.
You can eat a big fat dick. And cut!
Yep. Bye!
Bye.
It's all gone right now.
Penis. Get in with penis.
Penis!
In your end.
Jesus.
I said penis.
It's 3:30.
Say it louder.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Penis.
Fuck?
Wow. Yeah, you have to say it louder.
Yeah.
If you want to.
Penis? I think that should be 2 episodes.
Really?
Yeah, I think we just should edit it.
Like Monday and... When do you release them?
We don't really see
that would mean that they'd be 45.